My name is Peter Venišek. I work as a senior programmer at Mad Finger Games, and we are going to talk about Death Trigger, our latest game here at Gamescom 2012. We have a close relationship with Nvidia, especially with Igor Staněk, who is EMEA PR manager, and the relationship works in a way that we are cooperating like on development of our games. We are borrowing some devices from Nvidia, and especially for the Tegra 3 or the next devices, we are having some dev kits and such stuff. Well, you know, the chips are pretty powerful, so we can do all we want, and we can do a special effects, especially for Tegra 3 or such a powerful chips. And so with that trigger, for example, we were able to have up to 6 ragdolls at one time on screen in our game, and we are also having some special effects, some special shaders, high quality, and we are able to render the game in pretty high resolutions. For example, on characters, we have a lot more polygons than on other chips, on other devices. We also have some more like reflections on objects, and all is pretty much high detail, like the models and such things. For Android devices, you have two options. You can play the game with the touch screen, so we have a virtual joysticks, so you can either set it static, that it's on the screen all the time, and also you can have it like dynamic, it appears where you touch the screen. And we also do have support for many gamepads, so you can attach a gamepad to your device, attach it to the high definition screen, for example, and play the game as on console. The storyline is about this year, about 2012. We thought that it might be interesting for us and for the players to make the game about the current events. So basically, the storyline starts with the collapse of economy this year, and about the following events. So the people pretty much you know kill all the politicians because they didn't do their job well, and they allowed these things to happen. But those people who were like controlling the whole stuff behind disappear, they escape, and they use the technologies and the bunkers and the stuff that they developed before for them, like for as a hideout. So and then they release a virus which is a like biological weapon to kill all the rebellions, you know, to kill all the humankind, in fact. But not all the people die, so many of them turn into zombies, and then you as a hero in the game are there to fight against them. FPS shooter, of course, is a zombie shooter, but we focused on making quite a short levels. So basically the experience is that you select a mission, and then in the game you play the mission like 4-3 minutes, and you gain some experience points, you gain some money for it, and then you can evolve your character, so you can buy some weapons, you can buy some gadgets, some equipment, you can buy some other things, like extend your character or improve your character, upgrade some stuff, and so on and so on. We have two currencies. We have a shop, of course, and we have two currencies. One is called dollars, which you can earn in the game while you are playing, and we have also golds or gold fingers, which is a currency that you can either earn in the game by, for example, clicking on some Tabijoy or other services, or you can buy it for real money, and then you can buy some special things. But our game, it's important, is free to play, so you can play it through without paying any real money. When we were thinking about what should be the theme of the game, the zombies were quite straightforward solution. We had very limited time frame for the game, so it was quite obvious that we should make something that's pretty quick to create, in this respect, and that's basically it. You know, basically we are almost able to do all that you can do or what you could do in the past, just not console. So that's pretty exciting for us. We can do all the nice graphics stuff that was able or possible on consoles before. And what's especially interesting is that with most of the devices, you can connect the device to a pretty high definition TV, and you can control it with a gamepad. And you know, so you have your device, you can take it to the tram, and you can play there on a bus stop or everywhere, and then you to take it to home, and you continue with the same game, but on a high definition TV, which is really good.